Hello friends, today we'll see pointers in C in different manner. These are the contents of our today's session. Variants of pointers, like we can use pointer as a single pointer, double pointer, array of pointers and pointer to arrays. What are these different variants of pointer that we'll see one by one. What are the objective of our today's session? At the end of this session, you will be able to make efficient use of pointers. You will be able to identify the need of pointers in C program, as well as you will be confident about use of pointers in C. Now let's see the first variant of pointer, that is single pointer. Three examples are declared in our slide. They are integer, pointer alpha variable, character pointer ch variable, float pointer s variable. What are these three different variables? Here alpha, ch and s are declared as pointer variables. It means variables capable holding an addresses. From above declaration, we can say that integer alpha does not mean that alpha is going to hold integer value, but it means alpha is going to hold address of integer value. Same is for ch and s in above declaration. That means ch is a variable going to hold only of type character value, address of only character type value. S is a pointer type variable which can hold the address of only float type value. Here note is like addresses are always going to be whole numbers. It means pointers always contains whole numbers only. Now let's go forward for a next variant of pointer, that is double pointer, or it is also called as pointer to pointer. Now all of us are knowing what is pointer. Pointer is nothing but a variable. It is not an ordinary variable, but it holds the address of another variable. We can think like, is there any variable which can hold an address of another pointer variable? Now let's think about that more than two pointers are there in our program, and with that can we store the address of pointer variable in another pointer type variable? So now let's see the program which is available over here. This is a C program in which we have declared three variables, all of type of integer. The first one is integer I equal to 3, pointer j, and somehow two asterisks are there, pointer k. Now let's go through the program. J is a variable which is holding an address of I. K is a variable which is holding the address of j. Now let's think about what will be the output of this program. Here we are displaying the address of I, address of I, address of I in three different ways. That is address ampersand of I, which displays the address of I. J is already holding the address of I, that's why we are displaying a J. And value at the address K, K is holding the address of j, so that's why whatever value available at the address j is nothing but the address of I. That's why this is the third way to display the address of I. Now here the next two printf statement is displaying the address of j with two different ways. The first one is itself address ampersand of j, and the second one is nothing but the content of j. K is holding the address of J, that's why it displays the address of J. And now the next printf statement, to display the address of K, we need to use the ampersand K symbol to give the address of K. Now look forward to display the values available with the variable I, with variable K and with variable J. Value of I is going to be displayed with these four different ways, where just as it is, I, display I. Next one, value available at the address of I, it displays again, the value available at the address I is nothing but 3. Next, value available at the J is nothing but J is holding the address of I. We can say that this address of I is going to be replaced with J, and it displays the value available at the address of J is nothing but the 3 again. And the last one, we can say that now the pointer K is nothing but the value available at the I again. As we can say that the double pointer K, value available at the address of K is nothing but a double pointer. And the next two remaining two printf statements are, value of J we are going to display with the J itself, and value available K we are going to display as a K itself. Now with this program we can say that here is the answer of above question. Question was, can we think like, is there any variable which can hold an address of another pointer variable? So yes, the answer is yes, we can declare a variable which can store an address of another pointer variable, as J was itself a pointer variable and its address we have stored in another pointer variable. For that we need to declare it as a double pointer, because it is holding the address of another pointer type variable, not of any ordinary type variable. This concept is called as double pointer. Now let's think what will be the output of this program. As I have already explained the output of this program, now let's see the output by considering some of the address locations. I, its address location and the value available at the I. J is pointing to I, that's why the address of I is stored at the J, it is having its own address location. K is a double pointer which is holding the address of J. Address of J is nothing but 65522, are the content of variable K, and its own address is 65520. Now with this diagram, you can go through the output of this program and you will come to know the concept of double pointer. Now notice given is like, when you run above program, the addresses that get printed might turn out to be different than that of the above program. And here at the end, the last printf statement was, value of I is displayed with the address, value at the address K. Now let's see, value available at the address K, the first star K is nothing but 65522. The value available at this address location is nothing but 65524. Now next star is nothing but, value at the address 65524 is nothing but 3. That's why it displays the value at I is nothing but 3, by displaying it with the help of double pointer. Now next concept is array of pointers. Now array of pointers, when we'll think about, let's first of all go through the declaration like array of integers or characters. In the same way, can we define an array of pointers? Yes, we can. Here the declaration is given like this. Array of integer pointers is declared like integer pointer array of 4. An array of pointers is nothing but the collection of addresses. All rules which are applicable to array of integers or characters are same applicable to array of pointers. Array of pointers can store the addresses of associated variables or addresses of array elements. Now let's go through the example where array of pointers is declared. Four separate variables are declared, I with some value, J with some value, K with some value, L with some value, and M is somehow index variable. We have assigned the array of 0 with the address of I, array of 1 with address of J, array of 2 with address of K, and array of 3 with address of L. This is the diagrammatic representation where I is declared with the value 31, J is declared, K is declared, and L is declared with its own values. Its own addresses are also there. But when we are going to assign the addresses to pointer array of pointers, it will look like this. Like array 0 will hold the address of I, array 1 will hold the address of J, array 2 will hold the address of K, and array 3 will hold the address of L. And with the help of this for loop, we can display the values available with array at the index M. Now again, with the help of figure, think about the output of a given program. You can pause this video, you can execute this code, and you can check the output, what it gives the output for the for loop. Now we'll go forward with the another program. Like here, A is an array with 4 values. Array of pointer is also declared and assigned with next 5 values. Sorry, A is also with the 5 values. Pointer, array pointer is also declared with the 5 values by starting with the A plus 1, A plus 2, A plus 3, and A plus 4. What do you mean by this representation? A is nothing but the base address of array A. A plus 1 will give the address of the element, first element, which is available in array A. A plus 2 is nothing but the address of second element, and so on. Here you can go through the representation where A is a variable with 5 values. A is an array type variable with 5 values, and address of 0th element is nothing but 65510 is stored at P0. Address of first element 65512 is stored at P1, and so on. Now let's go through the printf statement, what it will give the output. The first value which we are printing is nothing but P. Second value at address P, and the last value pointer, that is value at the address available with the P. Now let's think what will be the output of this program. You can imagine output of the program by going through the following diagram. Now what it will give the output? P will display the base address of array P is nothing but 65518. Next, value at the address P is nothing but the base address P, and value available at this address location is nothing but 65510. And now double pointer is nothing but value available at the address P is nothing but, first of all we'll solve this, value available at the address P is nothing but 65510, as we have gone through the representation over here. So the same thing will be replaced over here, and value available at the address 65510 is nothing but 1. So last percent D will display the value available at the address, base address of A. In this way, we can implement different variants of pointers in C.